day had come for the Sujin engines to return home. They had a splendid time, but missed their own rules. Back on Soda, the engines were bustling about, making sure everything was spick and span for the Fat Controller's return. A party was to be held, and everyone was excited. Jinty and Pug were on shunting duty. They were on hiatus from mainline work, as the two engines weren't seen fit.
Oh, silly cars! Why must we be stuck here? If they don't want us, we may as well leave.
Sorry, Jinty, but we've still work to do. Thomas and the others aren't back, so we must help.
Yes, I know. It's just, I'd rather not be spending my last day on the island stuck in this yard.
The two were upset, but worked hard. Engines were rushing about, making sure to keep good time, especially Oliver. The Great Western engine worked tirelessly. If he hadn't been so busy, Oliver might have noticed his brakes were loose. He had a run-in with Jinty days ago, and that worn them out. Oliver arrived at Napa. People were getting ready, and the station looked splendid. Boko was arranging some cars.
Hello, Boko. Thank you for helping out.
Why, of course. It'll be great fun.
I'm sure. Is that my train you're arranging?
Indeed. I'll be done in just a tick.
Righto. Carry on.
Oliver turned around and backed onto his train. He was rushing and bumped the cars.
Ow! Watch it, you lime on wheels!
Whew. I'll have no trouble from you, silly lot.
The cars were cross, and decided to pay Oliver out. Oliver puffed down the line. He was preparing to stop at Ellsbridge, when the cars took their chance. As Oliver was braking, the cars surged forward.
Whoa! On! Stop!
Jinty and Pug were resting in the yard when they saw Oliver rocket by.
Oliver, stop! I don't think he can.
Right then.
Without another thought, Jinty raced after Oliver.
Where are you going?
Come on!
Oh dear.
Wait up!
The two mainland engines darted after Oliver. He whistled helplessly as the two tried gaining on him. At last they caught him. Pug yelled to Jinty.
Get in front! I'll couple up behind!
He said. Jinty's wheels whirred as he got in front of the train. The guard carefully coupled Pug to the brake pad, and Pug applied his brakes. Jinty slowed to let Oliver catch him, and with both engines using their brakes, the train finally came to a halt.
Thank you very much. You're both very brave.
It's the least we could do, Jinty tried to say humbly.
The two escorted Oliver and his train back to the station. After that, they puffed and apple. The engines all waited for Thomas and the others to return. They waited and waited. Then they heard a familiar whistle. There the cavalcade was, steaming into the station. Everyone cheered and hoorahed. The Fat Controller stepped out from Annie and spoke to Mr. Roger Sam.
Thank you for looking after everything, he said.
It was my pleasure, Sir Topham. Still, it'll be nice being back on the Scarlowy.
I'm sure, said the Fat Controller.
After that, he walked over to Jinty and Pug.
Hello, it's nice to see you again.
Yes, sir, the engine said together.
I've heard about your adventures, and I must say, you two have a lot to learn.
The engine stiffened.
However, I also know you two were helpful in the yard, and responsible for saving Oliver. I must say, what a fine job you did.
Too right!
Therefore, you two are welcome to come visit the island again anytime. I would enjoy having such useful engines on my railway.
The two mainland engines were pleased. That evening, they sat and talked with the others about their stay on the island, and when it was time to leave, they said goodbye and looked forward to returning.